Okay, so first things first, you need to download an app called CQSSTV. So I'm gonna go into my app store, and you can see that I've already put it into the search bar here, CQSSTV, and it will be the first app that comes up, this SSTV Slow Scan TV. I've already downloaded it, but you can purchase it for about €3.60. So I'm just gonna go ahead and open that, and now we'll see some of the settings for the app. So in the top left-hand corner, you want to make sure that the mode is set to PD120. And the mode can be a little bit tricky sometimes when it has this auto start function on, because when you switch in and out of the app, it can change the mode. So just make sure that every time you come back into the app that that mode is set properly to PD120. Then you want to go down to setup in the lower left corner. You want to make sure that auto start, auto mode, auto save, and saved photos are all checked off, and that default phase is selected. Back to the setup and default SKU is selected. So now the app is prepared and we can do a little test to see and make sure that everything is working properly. I'm gonna click stop. One important thing to note with this app is that for some reason it isn't able to automatically switch in where it's pulling the sound from, so it has some different speaker options. So when we're doing this test at the moment, I'm going to click on the I here. And we're gonna see that there's iPhone that comes up and speaker that comes up. And sometimes if you have another Bluetooth item in the room, it will also pop up on this menu. But for this test, we want to make sure that iPhone is selected. And that's where it's gonna be getting the sound instructions from in order for the app to decode the image. When we do the web SDR version later, we're going to be using speaker, but I'll show you that again in a little bit. So make sure iPhone is selected. Then we're gonna go back, click stop, and we are ready to do a test. So I have my laptop here in front of me, which I'm gonna be using as an external speaker to give the sound to my app in order to do the decoding test. And I'm also using a pair of Bluetooth headphones that have a noise canceling mechanism on them, just because it makes the sound really clear and nice, and then I get a nice picture out of it. So to set up, I'm gonna go to the site here on my laptop, but I'll also show you it here on my computer in SoundCloud. It is PD120 SSTV test recording, and I'll just show you what that's gonna sound like. Okay. So now, in order to do the test and make sure that our app is working properly, I'll leave this app, go back into my CQSSTV. I'm gonna press start on the sound. And then if you notice that the color is a little off on the image that's coming in, you can just scroll left and right with your finger on the phone surface, and you can go to the correct phase in which the coloring is proper. Okay, great. So now we have the image, which is complete and it looks pretty good. So we know that the app is working properly. And if I want to take a look at that image, I can just go straight into my photos and it will automatically be saved for me. So now we're ready to prepare for an actual event. And the first step in that is that we need to have a web SDR. So I'm gonna go into my browser here, and you'll see that you can find a web SDR using this website, which is websdr.org. I've already got one set up. I'm gonna be using this VHF Goonhilly. I'm just gonna reload this. There we go. And I'm gonna switch over to the mobile version of this by clicking on the red text. And now we're gonna do a little bit of setup in here. So I wanna make sure that my frequency is set to 145.800. Go and done. And you'll see that the waterfall here has already moved. And then I'm going to make sure that my USB is switched over to FM. And then finally at the bottom here where it says more playback buffering, that is checked. And then we are ready to start the audio. So in order to start the audio here, I want to make sure that my iPhone speaker is on and that the volume is turned up to about 5. And then when I click tap to start audio, you can hear some static. So now when I close out of this browser and I go into the CQSSTV app, you'll hear that the sound is being pulled into the app. And this time we want to make sure that when we click on the I, there we go, that speaker is checked. So now when we're decoding the image from the real SSTV event using the web SDR, it's going to be pulling the sound directly through the app here. And now you are ready to do real decoding from the ISS. So the next step is that you need to wait for the ISS to pass over a web SDR location. And so you can look for when those events are going to be happening by going to the RSTV blogspot, this website here. It will show you all of the upcoming SSTV events. And then one last step in preparation, we need one more app, which is called ISS Detector. I have it already downloaded here on my phone, but you can get it for free from the App Store. And when I open this, there are two important settings in here to look for. So the first is the location. So in this top right corner, you'll see that there's a menu. I'm going to check on that and I'm going to click settings. And then I want to make sure that use manual location is marked off because I don't want to be using the location of where I am, but I want to use the location of where the web SDR is located. So then I'm going to set the location, and you can do this by dragging the pin. I've already put it in here in the UK here, which is where the Goonhilly web SDR is located. And now that I have that all set, it's ready. And then one last thing we want to look for is you click on the filter and we want to make sure that visible sightings only is not checked off. We want to see visible and both non-visible sightings. And then we are ready to go. You can see all of the upcoming sightings. You can check when the next STV event is going to be happening. And then you're ready with your setup on your CQ SSTV app in order to decode a picture from the ISS.